you're a bit of seaweed. You're living in your own country, in your own land, attached to a piece of rock, happy as Larry. Your land is called here. There's a certain point, for reasons of history, need, necessity, desire, just takes your fancy, whatever, you decide that you want to move. You want to move and move on. So if you're a bit of seaweed, how do you move? Good question, I'll tell you. As it happens, your bladder rack. And you have this capacity for growing little air sacs at the tips of your fronds. And having decided to move, you summon up all your mental and intellectual and finance resources, whatever, and you grow these little sacs of air until at a certain point you achieve buoyancy and you can lift your rock. How about that? And then one day the tide's coming up and you do indeed have clear liftoff. And so you set off on this journey, which is going to take you from here to there. And by the way, you've got a couple of little friends who are coming with you, a couple of little barnacles who are hitchhiking a ride. And you get washed across seas, across oceans, until you come to a place which is called there. And you look at it, and you think, this would do me well. There looks like the right kind of place to me. So you allow yourself to be washed up on the beach, and you tell yourself you've arrived. But the problem is that the people of there don't want you there. They don't want random lumps of seaweed turning up on their beaches and deciding to live there. So what do? They pick you up and they throw you back in the sea to fend for yourself. And you're pretty depressed by this because it was a big effort to get yourself started in the first place. But anyway, you're tossed about a bit more by wind and water, and in the end you have a bit of luck because a particularly big wave comes and it tosses you up on the beach, up on the shingle. And you lie there and you go, whoa, I've arrived. But the problem is, you're out of your element. It's hot. The sun's burning down on you. And the sun is frittering you and brittling you and cracking you and drying you out. And what was once your green, beautiful, luscious, humid, desiring soul just becomes a dried out thing, desiccated, until you crack. And that's it, you're gone. But there you go. Another dead African on our beaches, who really cares anyway?